They have been making incredible music together for 44 years.
Wow.
What a band. We are so thrilled today to have Aerosmith co-founder and guitar legend Joe Perry with us this morning.
That's right. Joe is in town to promote his new book, Rocks, My Life in and Out of Aerosmith.
Brutally honest look at the band's music, their alcohol and drug use, sobriety, and the turbulent relationship with Steven Tyler. Joe, thank you so much for stopping by. I appreciate it, man.
Sure.
First of all, why the book? Why now? Is it kind of therapy for you? What goes into writing this?
When I was growing up, I always thought that, you know, an autobiography was something you did when you were, you know, going to retire and talk about your career and go off into the sunset and you've written your memoirs or whatever. But, you know, over the years in this business, I've realized that it's a calling that it's bigger than what the usual paradigm is. So I figured with the band's 40th anniversary, around the time I decided to do the book, and we were finishing our last record for Sony and a lot of different cornerstones, and it felt like the time to do it. Mm-hmm. And you know what? I can always add a couple chapters in the next edition if there is one, or the paperback or whatever. So up until we basically ended it till last year.
Yeah.
And all the 64 years leading up to that.
What's been the reaction from the band members from the book, especially Steven Tyler, with all the controversy there?
You know, I every guy I know has a different way of looking at things. We know each other probably all too well, you know, and so Brad phoned in and said he liked it. Joey said, you know, gave me kudos for telling the truth. Steven had only gotten about halfway through, but he called in, texted and said that he really liked it.
Really?
But I know he's on vacation down in Maui, so if I know him, and which I do pretty well, he's probably underwater a lot of the time. It's kind of tough to read while you're scuba diving.
Yeah. Yes,
and,
right.
Swimming, then
I haven't heard from Tom yet, but, you know, also knowing Tom, it may take him a while to digest it. Anyway, I think that overall it's been positive.
Touch a little bit about, of course, you think of Aerosmith, an extraordinary band, and it spanned those rock era ages that kind of it's synonymous with drugs and those kind of bands. But it wasn't a big part of your band. It was for a short time of your life, but
that's right.
But not the entire time. Talk a little bit about that.
Well, you know, I'm glad you brought that up, because so much has been made of the whole abuse and the drugs at the end, and you know what, you know, that was a big part of the band breaking up, or me leaving the band in 79. Mm-hmm. but also the years that it really affected the band, where I felt like we weren't putting on the best shows we could, we weren't making the best music we could make, was really 4 or 5 years, I would say. Mm-hmm. And then I left the band, and they were still together as Aerosmith, you know, playing gigs and, you know, doing whatever they were doing. I was doing my own thing.
Why did you leave the band, John?
Well, it was a lot of pressure. I mean, we were going basically from day to day. Either we were in the studio or we were on the road. And our personal lives were so intertwined with the business, we had to learn how to separate that. Mm-hmm. So we could really, you know, put all our focus in the band and not take it home with us. Mm-hmm. You know, and go, that guy did this to me, that, you know, I'll insert swear word there. you know, really, it was about that. And I think that by me leaving the band, and then Brad leaving the band, it gave us time to kind of reflect and also deal with the things that were going on in our personal lives that were also part of the reason why I left. But it took a while for us to figure out what was going on after the dust settled, you know?
Can we talk about your beautiful wife? Because she's in studio. Yeah. She is super sweet. Billy, you guys have been together, I think, for over 30 years, around 30 years.
Yeah.
So how have you, I think people may be shocked at that number. You've had so many highs, you've had so many lows. How have you guys stayed together? How have you raised your awesome kids during some of those lows?
It's when I met Billy, I mean, I was at a point with my band, I was kind of trying to decide whether I was going to keep the project together or move on and work with some other people. And I'd been away from the band for 5 years.
Right.
And so it wasn't like I walked around with a big Aerosmith on my chest. Mm-hmm. You know, I mean, I was just playing clubs. And in fact, when she heard about the band, she didn't even know it was my band.
Yeah.
She thought it was like the Jay Giles band, mm-hmm. where the guys, the guitar player is the band, but really it's Peter Wolf out there mm-hmm. up front. And so when she first saw me play, she thought, well, the guy's pretty good, you know. He might have potential if he gets seen by the right people. Mm-hmm. Not knowing anything that went on in the 70s,
sure.
which I thought was just fantastic to meet somebody that liked me for me,
mm-hmm.
and not
wasn't
like
chasing
the guy
you as
up
a groupie.
On stage,
right.
Cause he'd been playing in front of 60,000 people yeah. and all that. So that account is a real blessing, yeah. and I felt true love for the first mm-hmm. time, and I knew in that moment. And one of the things we said was, we're not going to be apart. You know, I'm not going to leave you home every other week and all that. I mean, I think that's so important to stay together. And then when we decided to have a family, the family's coming on the road with us.
What's the best thing about your life right now?
I think that we've kind of got a kind of detente on the personal level as far as dealing with each other. And I mean that in a very positive way. Mm-hmm. And also letting the creative part really work. I mean, I have no compunctions about getting into an argument with Steven or the other guys about how I feel the music should go, mm-hmm. or them telling me the same thing, which I think is an important part of the dynamic.
Wasn't it always like that?
Well, no, because like I said, we always brought it home, mm-hmm. and we'd always take it personally.
Mm-hmm.
But it's not that. It's like you're in the studio, you work, you have your differences, and you resolve that, and then you get the Walk This Ways or the Sweet Emotions mm-hmm. or the Kings, all the songs that have become part of our repertoire. But the main thing was not taking that out of the studio. Mm-hmm. And now Steven and I can go at it head to head in the studio, and then the next minute we're riding home on our motorcycles together,
mm-hmm.
you know. And so that's been the upshot of it. And well, part of the reason I wrote the book was to explain to people how hard it was to reach that point and how hard it's been to keep the band
and
together.
And there's a lot of misconceptions, too, out there that you probably want to clear up in the book.
Well, you know, Steven has a way of, putting out his story that's, may or may not coincide with the way I saw things.
Mm-hmm.
So I really wanted to set the record straight, not just from Steven's, the things he said, but just over the years, the so many things that have been put out in the press about, mm-hmm. you know, Steven and I or
sure.
the rest of the band and a lot of things. And frankly, during the 80s and 90s with our manager, Mr. Collins, it was turned into a very strange circumstance that I think the fans will be really fascinated by. Mm-hmm. I'm still fascinated by it when I read it.
We're fascinated by it.
Yeah,
you touched so much,
good.
And it's a pleasure to have you here, and to talk about your wife in such a great way is wonderful to hear.
It is
you
so
have
nice
a beautiful life.
I wouldn't be here if it wasn't for her. I have to lay it out there. I mean, I was like, I was partying pretty hard, mm-hmm. and when I found her, or she found me, it gave me a whole new reason to live,
right,
you know, and
right.
it really kind of
it
did that. And then I said, you know, I'd really like to have, you know,
it's a blessing to find your soulmate.
Mm-hmm.
That's
yeah.
a blessing.
How many children do you guys have?
Well, we have four all in.
Wow.
And
anybody interested in music?
Yeah, the two middle boys are they had a band for a while called Tab the Band,
and
then they call it Dirty Boots. But they've got other callings as well, and one of them is a lawyer practicing in New
wow.
York, and the younger one is moving out west to engineer and produce. He produced all their music, and
very
he's actually quite talented.
Yes.
We thank you for opening up, sharing your story with us today, and we do want to tell you, Joe Perry will be at the Rock Hall today for a book signing. He's there from noon until 2 o'clock. You can head over to our website, fox8.com, click on Morning Show tab for all the information on how you can meet him, have him sign your book. What an honor to have you here,
it
and a true pleasure. You're a great guy.
You are
thanks
super nice.
Yeah,
you really
really,
are.
Super
nice.
We didn't know what to expect.
I don't know what to expect.
We don't want you to leave.
I'm not the guy that, you know, like, is out there, like, you know, just blah. Yeah. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
And, I mean, I let the music do the talking. I mean,
right.
I know it's a cliche, but, you know, I love to play the guitar and I love to entertain the fans. But, you know, when I have something to say, I say it. And very often it comes out through the lyrics and the songs that I write.
What's your favorite Aerosmith song? What would you say? What would you say is your favorite song that you guys produced?
Well, I think that the one that kind of typifies our particular sound and that funk element that a lot of rock bands don't have, I think Walk This Way is the one that carries the day. And also the fact that we worked with Run DMC. And when we play it live, I mean, they hear that first riff and everybody's up.
What is that riff again? How's that go, Joe? We love it.
Thanks so much.
Thanks for stopping by.
You're so great.